everyone. Listen, I must say one thing. I need a lot of crowd participation. Okay? The one thing in my CV that I say is that I'm the best Bollywood dancer in London. Yeah? So if you promise to give me lots of energy, I can even do Bollywood moves for you. Okay? No, I'm actually, me Kolhapur chi ahe, born and brought up in Kolhapur. I'm a Kolhapuri at heart, Kolhapuri in the food I eat, I'm totally Kolhapuri. And it's hard for me to say no when Rajeshri invites me, because you are the future of Kolhapur. You are the future of making a difference, not just to Kolhapur, but you can to the entire world. So let me tell you a little bit about me. Would you like to hear a little bit about me? Okay, and then I'm going to share three life lessons with you. And then I'm going to open it up for questions and answers. Because, you know, one of the things is I like questions from the audience. Manje mala kalta ki kutpat kallela hai. Okay, so I like a lot of questions from the audience. So let me tell you a little bit about me. I grew up in Kolhapur. I was born in Kolhapur. I grew up in Kolhapur. I went to Holy Cross Convent School. That was the only school for girls at that time. And in 7th standard, the girls had to all go to St. Xavier's if their fathers allowed them to, and study in St. Xavier's school and complete their education. Now, when my batch came to the 7th standard, the school grew. From 7th, it became 8th. From 8th, it became 9th. From 9th, it became 10th. And we became the first batch of Holy Cross Convent. So when I was growing up, if somebody had told me that I would have a chance to do everything I'm doing today, have a chance to talk to the British Prime Minister about how to invest in Britain, or have a chance to change the fortunes of Unilever, I would not have believed it. Okay? So one of the lessons I will tell you about is to truly, truly dream big. Everything is possible. So I was just saying that I was from the first batch of Holy Cross. I then went to New College for 2 years, did my 11th, 12th in New College. One of the things growing up I was very good at was I was very good at studies. I was very focused and hardworking, because I felt I will not get these opportunities. I was grateful that the school had become up to 10th standard, so I really, really worked hard. I then decided to do engineering in electronics and telecommunications. Went to Sangli. I was among 18 women and 3,000 men in Walton College of Engineering, Sangli. And so my story, I've always known what it is to be the first woman doing something. It's been a privilege of my life, but it's also been a burden. I then did my management studies in XLRI Jamshedpur and joined Hindustan Unilever. So I did my MBA in XLRI Jamshedpur, joined Hindustan Unilever as a management trainee. You know, I used to cycle every day to go to New College and back, 12 kilometers up and down. And it was very easy to believe that I would not get the opportunity to do what I'm doing today. People would discourage you all the time. The number of people who would ask my father, ki tumhala donuts muli hai, you have just 2 daughters, you have no boys. So my huge encouragement to all of you, to all the boys, and especially all the girls, is please dream big. If I had believed all the people who said, tu mulgi hai, kai karna rahe, you're not going to have a career, I would not be here today. So please dream big. Don't let anyone else tell you how big your dream should be. You determine how big your dream should be. Yeah? We are very fortunate that we come from Kolhapur and we have so much love and support with us. Doesn't matter if you're young, old, accomplished, where you come from, nothing of that matters. You can make a difference. And this came to me really alive when in 2008, my husband and I was stuck along with 10 leaders of Unilever in Hotel Taj when the terrorists attacked on 26/11. Yeah. It was, without any doubt, the most difficult night of my life. Spending a whole night not knowing whether you'll come out alive is the most traumatic experience that you can go through. The whole night, it was bullets. We were stuck from 9:30 in the night to 6 in the morning, not knowing whether we'll come out alive. Bullets everywhere, debris falling down, people falling down, bullets. The whole night was bullets, debris. You could hear the screams of people. Very, very difficult night. But you know, one thing that I remember from that night was a very young girl called Mallika Jagar, who was only 24 years old, but was the leader of the staff serving us. You know, nothing in her training would have taught her what to do when terrorists attacked the hotel. Yeah? There is no training book called, if you're working in a hotel and terrorists attack, this is what you do. There is no workshop like that. There is no training workshop like that. So here was this 24-year-old girl, really looking after the top team of Unilever, and terrorists attacked the hotel. But she had such calm and composure through the night. When her mother was calling her from Jalandhar or somewhere, she told her mother, please don't call, I'm not in the hotel, so don't worry about me, because she didn't want her mother calling all the time when she was trying to help the guests. The whole night she kept trying to hide us. She put us in different corners, husbands and wives in different corners if something were to happen. And she looked after us so well that night, helping to give us whatever little information that she could find from the hotel staff. And early morning at 6 o'clock, when smoke started filling the room that we were in, we started to try to escape. And she took us through the back alleys of the hotel and took us to a place where we could escape, where the fire brigades came and helped us. And I remember my boss, who was 6'4", looking at this little girl and telling her that ladies first, gentlemen next, to climb down the ladder. And she was 24 years old, and she looks at him and she says, no, sir, this is my party, my rules. Guests will go first, staff of the hotel will go next, and I will come last. Yeah. That that is leadership. That is, if it's to be, it's up to me. You don't wait for anybody else to take leadership. If you think something needs to be changed in the school, you don't complain about it. You make a plan to see how can we change it.
Oh, I have many people who are my inspiration, you know. My father was very encouraging. He always told me that you can achieve anything in your life. Yeah? Because, you know, I remember when I was young in Kolhapur, so many people used to come to my father and say, you have an industry, you don't have a mulga, kasa honar. So just to make me feel very bad, because I'm a girl, am I not good enough? But my father always said, you can achieve anything you want in your life. You can fly, you don't have to think ki Kolhapur or this. You can fly, you can go in the world, you can make a difference to anything.
Thank you.
So
ma'am,
he was a huge inspiration for me. Okay, I want you to walk knowing that being from Kolhapur, you can do many, many things with your life. You can have a huge impact. Yeah? So go with confidence, go with inspiration, make a difference in this world. The world really needs young people like you to make a huge difference. Thank you very much. Marathi, of course. Mala Marathi agdi chhan yeto. Mi bhashan deu shakte Marathi madhe.